My dear Ellie, I have to find her.
I've been arguing with John about how many actual days have passed since we ended up here. It seems that all of our hopes are drifting away, like these bottles should do. They always return to the island as if something is leading them back here. If you are reading this, we need your help. A shred of hope. Oh, what a man needs to keep moving before he loses his sanity and his will. Walking along the shore reminded me of the walks I used to have with my wife. Ourselves and walked along the shore. To our surprise, we came across other ships that had wrecked without any trace of survivors. It was like a graveyard for ships. Our compass goes mad any time we try to set a course off the island. Our captain says it's because of the volcanic dust. We think he's gone mad. Sounds like the captain was right. They speak of a fisherman who was lost in a stranded sea. He never came back. Now I know where he lies. What misfortunes could have drove him here?
I've offered my right arm and spoke the correct words in his absence. Only pain accompanies me towards my demise. I was forced to leave the lighthouse. There's something wrong in all of us. Only the slumbering god can save us now. What god is he talking about? As we sinked our feet in the sand for the last time, she asked me to tell her one of my stories about the wild sea. I could hear each of her breaths being shorter and shorter. And by the time I finished my story, pneumonia took her life.
proceed into the beat. There's something I would like to show you.
What is that voice? Get out of my head!
Of light. Beware the existence of mine, and grasp time in your conscious mind.
swear I saw something towards the horizon. Behind the mist, it wasn't a whale, or a great white shark. Its many legs stretched 100 feet, submerging its body into the sea. It crawled as if it was infected by 1,000 parasites. From its tentacle mouth, it spit out black, disgusting, and disfigured blob-like figures. The moment they fell into the sea, they swam away faster than a dolphin. As the mist kept rising, I could barely see the creature. That wasn't a good sign. I should start placing those talismans I found at the bottom of the lighthouse around the pathways we made. Uneducated fools. They won't let me write for them. They're all fishermen with dirty, scuffed clothes and smell horrible. Their beards reek of alcohol and spit comes out when they talk. I'd rather stay another 4 hours at this point and take care of the problematic mechanisms of this handcrafted construct. I do not regret this journey. It certainly made life more interesting since then. Not to mention the view from up here. All of the hatred, misery, and sadness of mankind fade away into the line where the sea and the sky collide. He is not wrong there. It is a hell of a view.
Thank you.
Stop it! It's not my daughter's voice.
They managed to let him die in here. What made them forsake their civil ways? As a young boy, I remember my father talking about this island. He described it in a way that would scare the listener. He spoke of black butterflies, corpse candles, and broken compasses.
There was a man aboard named Alan who went missing after we shipwrecked. One night, we found him walking alone across the beach. As we approached him, to our surprise, we saw that he had this fixed expression on his face, as if he had seen something horrifying. His hands and arms were paralyzed in a position like if he was protecting himself from something. We tried to ask him questions, but he didn't reply. Now he's sitting by the shore, singing songs to the rocks about reflections in the sea. I wonder what he saw.
This island feels like it's maintained, untouched by time. The wind and the waves pause for a minute to rest. A calm before the storm.
I'm sending this message as a cry for help. May the waves of the sea be kind. The pollen and I are castaways, trying to find where this island is on the map. This doesn't make any sense. The sun is setting in the east, and the fog won't allow us to see through the scope that far. The odds are against us. There's something strange about Apollon. He keeps going on about how he's reliving this moment. I noticed how much he scratches the back of his head. It's gotten to the point where his hair is beginning to fall out. If you are reading this, we need your help. Describe what I have witnessed today. That old fool Alex suddenly went insane. He started stuffing his mouth with rocks. He kept doing so until his cheeks were completely torn. We had to tie him down. If you're reading this, send help. There's definitely something wrong with this guy. Small whale. I recognize this boat. It was made by an artist to represent our greatest catch. How did it end up here? This was meant to be completed by the end of December. It's still September.
Despite his fear about the island, he would often come here fishing some very colorful fish. I remember finding myself quite disturbed as I watched him stuff his mouth with their raw meat. place feels like it was always a part of me. As if it has taken a hold of me and won't let go. Another foot in the sand, but this time sink deeper beneath the shore.
Day 30. Elliot is trying to put together the broken parts on a boat we found. If he manages to build it, then we might have a chance of escaping this place. We have to try at least. There's only 3 of us left now in our crew. We can't afford to waste any more time here. As if time exists in this place. I think I'm starting to lose my mind. I can hear my breath after a screeching sound pierces my ears. If you are reading this, then don't look for us.
Looking upon my daughter's toy gave me some sort of happiness. Yet I can't take my mind off the idea she's been taken by one of those creatures.
It's not my fault. A person has already died here. Jay spoke about a shadow whispering between the rocks. We can't stay on this island anymore. We have to leave now.
Solitude and peace is what a soul seeks after being free. Did they die in vain? It appears they were murdered. What a horrible way to find solitude.
Anything to see her face again.
Thank you.
Shadow and I came to a curious sort of an agreement. My lack of empathy has phased out any trace of fear. How did my monotonous self come closer and closer to the fact that nothing surprises me anymore? Have I lost my humanity?
Not lost, but discovering its new potential. How far will you go, Andrew? How far will you go for her?
I would fall into the darkest pit to save her.
So be it.
Thank you.